In the last video, we discussed pH of strong acids, and now we're going to look and see how things change when we determine the pH of weak acids. Here we're asked, what is the pH of a 1.0 molar HF solution, which has a Ka of 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4? Now, since we have a weak acid like HF, when we put it in an aqueous solution, we're going to have an equilibrium expression. So the HF plus H2O liquid is going to give us H3O plus in aqueous solution plus F minus in aqueous solution. Here we know that the concentration of the HF is not going to equal the concentration of the H plus ions in solution, and we're going to have to use the Ka in order to determine this. So just like we did in the equilibrium chapter, we're going to set up an ice table here indicating our concentrations. Initially, we have a 1.0 molar concentration of HF. The water does not show up in the equilibrium expression because its concentration is going to be constant. Our H3O plus and our F minus are going to start out with a concentration of zero. As the equilibrium is established, the H3O plus concentration and the F minus concentration are going to be plus X, and the HF will be minus X. So at equilibrium, we have 1.0 minus X, X, and X for all of our concentrations. If we set up our Ka expression, it's going to be the concentration of H3O plus times the concentration of F minus divided by the concentration of HF. This is going to equal 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4. If we now plug in our equilibrium concentrations, we're going to have X times X divided by 1.0 minus X equals 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4. This will give us, if we distribute everything out here, we're going to have X squared equaling 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4 minus 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4. Okay, we can now say that X squared plus 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4 X minus 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4 is going to be equal to 0. From here, we can apply our quadratic equation, and if we do that, X is going to be equal to 2.7 times 10 to the minus 2. Now, anytime we are looking at equilibrium concentrations, we have to figure out what we just determined X to be. In this case, X is going to equal 2.7 times 10 to the minus 2, and that equals the concentration of H3O plus, which also equals the concentration of F minus at equilibrium. Okay? So to calculate the pH, we need this value, or we go with the negative log of H3O plus, and our pH is going to equal our negative log of 2.7 times 10 to the minus 2, which is going to equal 1.6. So to recap everything here, if we're trying to determine the pH of a weak acid, we set up our equilibrium expression for our weak acid. We're given the Ka being 7.2 times 10 to the minus 4. We set up an ice table, write out the Ka expression, go through, use the quadratic equation to solve for X, look back up at our ice table to see that in this case, X is going to be equal to the equilibrium concentrations of the H3O plus and the F minus. Really, the H3O plus is what we're looking for here. Use our pH equals the negative log of the H plus concentration, then plug in the value for that H plus concentration, take its negative log, and in this case, it becomes 1.6.